Respected Deputy Chairman, we have travelled from the ancient times of Kamadenu to the political animal that is called cow. Just on January 30, we observed the 70th death anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, who taught to pray cow and to allow the freedom of choice of rearing, breeding, and its ongoing process. The present day agenda of the ruling party and the diversionary tactics of the parallel organizations of the ruling party is having the terrifying impact all across the country. In this backdrop, I appreciate Dr. Subramanian Swamy for bringing in this private bill for focusing the topicality of the cow protection. His intention is just for an authority, a national authority to protect cow. For that, though he is nominated in nature but very important member of the ruling party, he could have impressed upon the union government to come with the requisite legal legislative remedies to ensure the authority and to take all the states on board for at least from the present day union government ruling party to adhere to, so that the congenial and harmonious environment could be evolved within the society. I am mostly bothered about the problems of the farmers, of those who are rearing cows individually. I am a regular visitor to Goshalas. In my childhood, in my family, we used to have Kamadenu like cows. With that reverence, we have our own attachment with the heritage and the spiritual value, besides the nutritional value of cow milk and cow byproducts. But what is happening to the small farmers, those who are having the cows with them? Wherever you could find the big farmer, wherever you could see the dairy promotion, you will find blood sucking like milk sucking, milk extraction missions, which are giving total ill health to the cow population. Have you ever bothered about the health of the cow that is giving milk? It has become just an agenda to divert the real issue of cow health. Cow farmers in bunches, they will have, they will also try to have the ox, and their rearing capacities will get exhausted after 3-4 levels of rebirth, and then the farmers are left with nowhere to go. Something like Nilgai-like situation in Bundelkhand. They are not able to feed them. Yes, Indian Constitution has ensured through Articles 38 and 47 for the protection and promotion of cow and animal husbandry. But have we ever ensured the non-milking, non-milching cows to be taken care of. The member who has moved the present bill, private in nature, was the commerce minister besides several portfolios. His present day union ministry of commerce is having separate committee to promote cow meat, that is beef, export and its expansion of the export activity. Have we ever really looked at? We are not addressing the real issues. We are giving just emotional tinge to the aspects with which we can polarize, we can exploit, we can divert. There are several extraordinary breeds in India, but today we could find the cow breed only in properly promoted and very well established mutt owning trust owning goshalas. Why this situation is happening? Why we are so much unconcerned towards the protection of those breeds? To find such breeds, we need to travel to Vrindavan. We need to travel to Kanneri Mutt of Kolhapur, Maharashtra. We need to travel to several parts of Gujarat. But we are not regularly seeing them in our fields and in our homes. This Jersey cow is becoming a burden to the farmer. Come on, give the answer to the small farmers who are facing with their poverty in feeding those cows, which are not giving any milk anymore. This situation has to be properly looked at. Cow is always having the spiritual highness. In Indian Vedic livelihood, yes, cow will sustain to have the respect, and it will also continue to have the nutritional value. But can this Food Authority of India ensure the present day pocketed milk is having anywhere near the value of the cow milk? Just now the member, while moving his bill, mentioned about the soya bean milk. Wherever we go, we are not sure in restaurants and hotels about the quality of the milk. And people are worried in purchasing the pocketed milk. They are thoroughly convinced that these are not at all healthy. But as the children, as the elders have to be fed with, they were being provided this adulterated milk products. We have to have the holistic view towards total cow population. Cow protection encompasses the protection of the farmers, those are having the cows. We need to look at that angle, and a blind authority without any role to really execute on the ground is not going to help in any way other than highlighting and making some political statement. Let the Kamadenu, let the cow, does not become political tool, political animal. Already human beings are all political animals, but this cow getting its own problem due to the mechanization of the milk sucking and the excessive extraction of the milk is giving its ill health to it. Let us focus about the health of the cow instead of diverting it to the political agenda. I plead the union government to look at the farmers' issues, those who are having the cow in their rearing, for their supporting, and so that they can safely continue to sustain the cow population in our rural milieu. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Rapalu.